Mask mandate in New York now in effect. The new rule requires everybody to mask up indoors at all public places. The one exception, if a business or venue asks for full proof of vaccination to get in.
All right, but some county leaders, they do not plan on enforcing this mask mandate.
So that includes Nassau County's incoming county executive, Bruce Blakeman. He's joining us from Atlantic Beach, Long Island this morning. Nice to have you back, Mr. Blakeman.
Thanks.
So,
good morning.
Why are you opposing this mask mandate right off from the start?
Well, we have about 1.5 million residents in Nassau County, and 97% of our adult residents have been vaccinated. We don't have any issues with hospital bed capacity. We have plenty of capacity, and our ICU units have plenty of capacity. So we're not in crisis in Nassau County. The governor made this mandate because there are problems in other parts of the state, particularly in the Buffalo region, which is 300 miles from Long Island. It's closer to Cleveland than it is to Long Island. So the problems up there are not the same problems that we're experiencing down here. So we want local control. I've talked to our health commissioner. He's very comfortable with the position that I'm taking. And we're not gonna enforce mask mandates unless or until, and hopefully that never happens, we have a crisis. We do not have a crisis now. We need to get back to normal.
So I was wondering, have you heard from the governor and have you heard from any other health officials that are telling you you should rethink your position?
Well, I not only consulted with our health commissioner, but I've also consulted with other physicians that are part of my transition team, and they're very much in accord with what I'm doing. I have not heard from the governor's office as of yet. But again, the governor made a statewide mandate. We believe local control is the way to go because we have a very big state. And the things that are happening up in Buffalo bear no resemblance to what's going on here in Long Island.
What does that say to the governor in terms of how she's doing with this crisis when she makes a mandate and she also says, hey, it's up to local governments to enforce this? What does that say to the general population? It seems like one broad mandate is not working for all.
Yeah, well, it's a broad brush, and that's what we're saying. But this is a very complicated problem, and obviously it's a concern. But when the governor does things like this, it makes people very cynical. And I think that's a danger because if there is a crisis, people will not pay attention. So I think that you have to take it on a day-to-day basis. You have to evaluate the data, look at the science, and you also have to use common sense. We can't shut down our whole economy again. That is something that would be devastating to people. We don't know the mental health aspect of this whole coronavirus with making children wear masks and people losing their businesses and losing their jobs. There's more to it than just looking at the healthcare issues with respect to the virus itself. There's also the ancillary issues and the collateral damage of mental health that we have to look very carefully at.
Now, you guys have a 97% of adults rate that are vaccinated in your county, which is great. But do you credit that to one thing or maybe one person as to where you're at now with that high percentage rate?
Well, I think that, you know, I'm on the Hempstead Town Board still as a councilman, and we took the lead in the state. We were the first mobile vaccination unit in the state of New York, and we partnered up with Mount Sinai Hospital, and we also did free testing with Northwell Hospital. So we were at the forefront of this, and Hempstead Town makes up 60% of the county. So we took the lead in this, and then the rest of the state started to follow our lead. So we were very aggressive in the town of Hempstead under the leadership of Supervisor Clavin and my colleagues on the town board in making sure that if people wanted a vaccination, that it was available.
So this mask mandate is temporary. The governor said she'd reevaluate mid-January. But at the same time, there is a big push to get people back to work, to stop the remote working. Does this mask mandate kind of like encourage people to stay home again? Why deal with a mask inside work?
Yeah, I think basically, again, as I travel around the county, people want to get back to normal. They're tired of the mandates. They want to be able to live their lives. And again, as I mentioned before, the collateral damage of the mental health issues, we're going to find that, that's a very profound issue with respect to coronavirus. And it's very complicated, so you can't paint a broad brush. You have to go on a day-to-day basis, consult with your medical professionals. You got to look into the science, but you also have to use common sense.
Right. Bruce Blakeman, incoming Nassau County executive. Hey, when do you get sworn in?
Officially, I get sworn in on January 1st at midnight. My wife, Sigal, who's a judge, will swear me in, but my inauguration is on January 3rd at the Cradle of Aviation Museum. And you're welcome to come, both of you. I'd love to have you.
Thank you so much, Bruce. All the best to you and the family. Appreciate it.
Thank you so much.